supporting. I appreciate it. Appreciate it. So I'm releasing an album. It's called Real Life. It's based off of my life. You know, a lot of people or whatever that knew me, you know, 5 or 10 years ago or whatever, they kind of already know what was going on. But for the people that don't, you know, it's explaining stuff or whatever that really happened, you know, 5 or 10 years ago. You know what I mean? It's based off of my life story. That's why I chose to call it Real Life. You know what I mean? The official release date is going to be on my birthday, which is the 16th of this month. That's on a Wednesday, so that's going to be the official release date. I'm going to have it on all, you know, major platforms, you know, like Spotify, iTunes, Google Play, iHeartRadio.
My mixtape.
And all of that. My mixtapes is going to be Audio Mac, SoundCloud. Yeah, it's going to be on all of them. And right now, we're just going to get into the track list. Yeah. So the first, and if anybody, you know, I'm open for opinions. You know what I mean? I want y'all to. I take criticism, you know what I'm saying? So, you know, tell me what y'all like. Tell me what y'all didn't like. You know what I mean? And like the first track is going to be called Level Up.
Had no time to play, had to put in work. I had to get it on my own, I had to level up. My old friends hated on me, they was trying to hold me up. I had to take care of my business, had to level up. Had no time to waste, had to put in work. I had to get up on my grind, I had to level up. So many turned on me, I just had to level up. I cut a lot of people off, I had to level up. I remember when I first started in 2010. Started taking rap serious, I knew I had to give. Every young gave me a shot, to see I had a vision. He told me to work hard, don't give up and stay consistent. I remember all the late nights staying up thinking. Had to gather up my thoughts, it was times I couldn't sleep. So I grabbed my pen and pad. She got that work, it's under her skirt. It's under her skirt. Got to try to kill these niggas, I'm in hearse mode. Niggas tryna run my way, they gettin' they surf on. She saw a nigga gettin' a little money, then went up in thirst mode. Now I'm not into the hustle, place where I move with the muscle. Them niggas buzzin' like vultures. When they can't move me, I'ma sculpture. Had to stop chasing bitches, so I started chasing chips. Two months of Michael Slaughter, now I'm chasing next. Niggas tryna stop who shine. Hey man, I ain't got the heart for y'all, they don't get it. I'm a beast, and I'm hard, I'm a gargoyle. I'm about to all for it, and the type of war that I'm on for. Them other niggas, they be hardly working, everything I gotta work hard for. I can't imagine what you're going through, yeah. If I was broke, I might just feel it too, yeah. And money comes, so I always pick up.
I came from the dirt. I gotta work, yeah. Work. I gotta work. Yeah.
I'm moving in there, woo.
Yeah, that was
me.
That was self-explanatory.
I gotta work.
You just gotta work.
He said that.
That's so sick. No, he said it. Damn, boy. I don't know. That's got some comp in here.
Right. Y'all ain't about what y'all be talking about. I swear your fate. I'm raising up my standards, trying to get 100K. Y'all didn't believe me when I told you. Now I got it made. Now all I need is a big crib and a Wraith. I swear life is a gamble. That's why I'm raising up my standards. That's why I can't hang with no lanes. If you ain't talking about money, what you saying? Nobody helped, I had to take it. I remember I was broke, I had to fake it. Now I'm working on my flex, boy, I made it. Now I'm coming through them hundreds, living
big. The time where like my car and stuff, pretty much or whatever, to a point where I was like
home, like just
like
didn't have shit.
Yeah, didn't have nothing, man. Whatever, if it wasn't for my wife or whatever, like I don't know where I'd be at right
that's
now.
Lit.
You know what I mean? But like it was a time or whatever where I was really like actually like walking to work. So that's all I'm saying. Yeah, when I popped out, it was actually a job, but that I had before I was working at Popeye's or whatever. But like no, like real talk or whatever. Like it was the times where I was actually like walking to work, and that's why I'm saying I was walking in the rain because like it was raining. You know what I mean? And like cars were passing by. Honking, you know, hey, yeah, what up, man? I'm like,
excuse
I'm
me.
Walking, you know what I mean? So it was like, it was crazy. And then it was also a part in that verse or whatever I said when I was talking about my ex or whatever.
Yeah.
So pretty much or whatever, like, you know, I was with my ex or whatever, and like she cheated on me and stuff like that or whatever. So, yeah, so it's like saying some stuff about that or whatever. And it's getting like real, real personal. Whatever, talking about stuff or whatever that like a lot of people.
What was the name of that song right there?
It's called Raising Up My Standards.
Yeah, I like
or
that.
Or whatever. And I, just like I said, it was another part where I said I was trying to hit the studio. They laughed.
Hitting me, yeah. I'll
you know what I'm saying? Right, so yeah. Like,
I can relate to that.
Yeah, because it's like before, like I really like started taking like my music serious. You know, like I was real like quiet.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Like I didn't really talk a lot. You know what I mean? Like I. You know, kind of like socialize with a little bit of people, you know what I mean? But a lot of people didn't know I rapped.
Right.
You know what I mean? So like, you know, once I started getting serious, I was actually hitting up people, you know what I'm saying? Trying to get in the studio, and it was like, dude, rap. You know what I mean? Mm-hmm. It was like, this dude don't rap.
Right.
You know what I mean? But then when I started like actually like investing in my craft and like taking my craft like seriously or whatever, and like they was all like, oh, like this dude is serious. Like he actually like really trying to like
do
something. So like, they really didn't want me to get in the studio. Like I hit them up like, hey man, I'm trying to get in the studio. And they was like, nah man. Like, you know, that was on a low, like low key hating. So that's why I was like, you know, I was trying to hit the studio. They laughed at me.
Wow.
Now I'm out here making hits. They want to collab with me. You know what I mean? So now
crazy.
You know what I'm saying? So like, that's what that one is about. And it's called like Raising Up My Standards. Cause you know what I'm saying? Like, I was like, down low, now I'm raising up my standards. Now or whatever, like if you ain't really like
really about your shit,
I collab with you, you know what I mean? If I see you like really trying, but like everybody talking about they trying to rap,
everybody trying to rap, like capping and threatening.
Yeah. Yeah, so like it's like I'm trying to like, you know, set my standards up here, man. I'm like, I'm really trying to do something with this.
Big house, I'm up and I'm up now. Yeah. Making moves, I'm a boss now. Yeah. I'm a beast, I'm cold with it. I go hard, I run the town. I do this here cause I love it. I got a passion for it, I'm an artist. And I'm trying to tell my story. And I pray to God, y'all listen. I don't do it for the fame. And I do it for the fame. And I do it for my city. And I do it cause I love it. I don't do it for the hoes. I got a passion. Yeah. They should really hold me down. And I'm with her cause I love her. I don't do it for a deal. Yeah, I'm tryna make a meal. And I'm rolled up in a rave. And my brand new state. I don't do it for the drugs. I ain't tryna be a thug. I'm just tryna be me. I'm just tryna stay free.
That's funny because I remember, you know, like the whole like going through the whole recording process.
Yeah.
Like Milky, this, and I don't even know if Milky, I don't even know if you remember, but I remember like we was hitting each other up like through email. And like I was sending you some tracks and I was like, hey man, can you tweak this and tweak that? Like make this and sound that or whatever. And you was like, hey, he was like, do you not cut? Like, I don't know if you remember. And like he was like, do you not cuss? And he was like, no, like it ain't a bad thing or nothing like that. But he was like, do you not cuss?
I'm not like, lying, it should be good.
I cuss a lot. I somehow never noticed, and I was just sitting there like, wait a second.
Yeah, that's what I did. I was like, damn.
I didn't hear nothing like
how
fucking fuck boy.
I
didn't
hear nothing.
I'm
like, damn.
What would you do if you lost it all? You was asking for help, they had Norja
Cole. What would you do?
What would you do?
What would you do?
I can relate to this, bro, because when we was doing it, I was like, that won't be able to do this, bro. Now I leveled up and I'm like, South Texas Smith got it.
Had to get up and get.
I mean, if you don't scroll it, you know what I'm saying? I mean, throw it. Yeah. They gon' feel it.
Yeah, man. And that's really what I want people to do. Like,
yeah,
I want
feel it.
To learn, really, like, feel it. You know what I mean? And be able to relate to it.
A lot of y'all call me your homie, but really, I don't even know you. Nah. Bakery. Most of y'all smile at my face. Y'all act like y'all want me to win.